Oh, I get it. The universe is a trampoline.
You see, what the devil did with this heliocentric global universe, what he's done is, God says it looks one way, he says it looks like another. And what he's doing is the same thing he did with Eve, had God said. And what we're going to do, we're going to bring you through the Renaissance, we're going to bring you through the Age of Enlightenment, we're going to bring you through Newton, we're going to bring you through Kepler, we're going to bring you through all history, amen, as it relates to after the Copernican theory came out. We're going to bring you through all of that. And I'm going to show you how humanity changed. When the devil attacked the very foundation of our belief, he attacked Genesis on how creation looks, something happened to mankind. What happened to mankind? Well, if God is lying about this, if God can't be trusted about this, if the earth is not what God says it is, then what else did God say in his word that we can't depend on? And from that, people began to do, every man did what was right in his own eyes. It's a globe. It's a big bang. It's evolution. It's a man could be a woman if he wanted. A woman could be a man. Why trust anything God says? Hath God said? Hath God said? The devil knew what he was doing. Can we dealing with an angelic brilliance, dog? This is not the plot of a man here, no. When he changed the shape of creation, listen to me now. He did something to the hearts of men. You see, because if you can't believe how God say his creation look, what can you really believe? You see, something happened to me when I came to the revelation of how creation look. It strengthened me in so many areas of my walk. When I prayed, amen, I didn't have to feel my prayers was going so far. Are you with me here so far? You see, and when God sees you believe him on this basic level, I'm going to show you why it's basic, because nobody was there when he created. I'm going to show you that in a second. They're trying to tell you how it looked, but nobody was there. He told Job, where was you? Oh, God, have mercy. Oh, Lord, I'm trying to contain myself. When you believe him on this basic level, he's going to take you to places you ain't never been.
All right, Globies, you guys are killing me with these meltdowns you're having in my comment sections. Look, this is where you live, and this is where you've always lived. The Earth is flat. The sun and the moon are the same size. The sun overtakes the moon every month. And, oh yeah, we do think that the Earth is round on the edges, like a coin. See, we have that in common. Gosh, that looks a lot like the United Nations logo. Isn't it weird that all astronauts are Freemasons? Globies, you know that moon landing was fake. They made a phone call from the moon? And have you ever noticed that any image of a star or a planet or even the Earth that shows the entirety of the Earth is complete CGI? And have you ever noticed that any video close to the surface of the Earth is always with a fisheye lens? That's weird. What does that do to the horizon? How the one thing that all the countries of the world can agree upon is the penguins, and they all signed the Antarctic Treaty. And they forbid us to go there. Isn't it weird that the one star out of millions of stars that is above the North Pole is the only star that doesn't move? Magnetic North, anyone? Hey, Globies, tell me about Magnetic South. Okay, let's think. If the sun was moving at 448,000 miles per hour as we chased it in this elliptical orbit, do you think we'd have constellations? The same constellations that have been there since the start of time? Globies, why does a plane from Buenos Aires to Sydney have to stop in LA? It makes a lot of sense on this map, but it's thousands of miles out of the way on your globe. Globies, what's the mathematical probability that the sun and the moon are the same visual size and can perfectly eclipse? And what's with all these laser tests that are done over 50 miles of resting water that show no curvature when there should be miles of curvature? Whoa, that one's rough. All this flat earth stuff seems to match the Bible. Whoa. Uh-oh. It's okay. We got Jesus. And he died for my sins, and he died for your sins. Just gotta believe and follow. But you have to ask yourself, why are you so angry when you see flat earth videos? Is it because outer space is a religion by itself? Where are the stars in NASA footage? Why don't the planets have phases? They almost seem like lights themselves. Well, golly gee, outer space doesn't even exist. Have you heard about the firmament? Globies, I know all this stuff because I was once a globie. And I'd still be a globie if God didn't intervene. But the truth is good news. We were all created by God.
This is the last thing I'll say about Flat Earth. I don't give a fuck about any reports, any data, any, like, look at this news clip, look at this article, here's this study. I don't give a fuck. Here's why. I'm never going to appreciate the fact that you're okay with someone else telling you what your reality is. I know that I've never seen the Earth from space with my own eyes. I'm not going to rely on someone else saying, well, we've done the work for you. This is what it looks like. I might be inclined to believe it if there wasn't so much woo-woo surrounding it, right? Where is the dedicated television channel of the Earth spinning in space, uninterrupted, unobstructed? I don't give no fucks about research papers, articles, websites. Answer those simple questions. A four-year-old doesn't give no fucks about a news article. If you can't explain it simply, if you have to logic it away, if you have to intellectualize it away, you are lying to yourself. You've been taught how to lie really well. If you are not curious, I don't care to speak to you. Have a great life.
So I can't believe I'm going to make a topic video about this, but it's blown my mind, and it's just blown my mind. You got to understand something. I was a fireman and EMT. I fly RC airplanes. I've almost got my pilot's license. Helicopter pilot, amateur radio operator, so I understand electronics, how radio waves work, transmission of those radio waves, broadcasting of those waves, understanding the bounce off the ionosphere, how to make an antenna, its specific wavelength for the transmission on a specific channel. I know how to do all of that personally myself, and I'm going to tell you that the world is flat. The Earth is not round. It is flat. I can't believe I say that. I have fought many a fight about this, but about a month ago, or maybe two, somebody was like, what is $50,000 to prove the world's round? I'm like, what? How is that even a thing? So I looked into this, and this is a real thing. You can get $50,000. Go ahead and prove the world's round. You can't. When you mathematically do all the equations of how far, you know, our world is 15,000, you know, 25,000 miles in diameter or circumference, and all the way around, you can see 3 miles out before the curvature of the Earth should drop out of view. You can see 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80. You can see well 100 times that distance out. Propagation of waves would not allow you to send a channel. I can broadcast a signal from here on a perfect day to the other end of the world, to Korea, China, wherever, somewhere like that we have legal treaties with. I can broadcast signals to these people, and they can broadcast back to me. That wouldn't be possible because what they say in amateur radio is that your signal travels up to the ionosphere, bounces back down to the ground, and hits it. You would have to do that more than 5 times to get to this side of the world if the world was not flat. That's not possible. Why do you lose Sirius radio and all satellite communications when you go out into the deep part of the ocean? I live in North Carolina. I go deep sea fishing. I've been 50 miles, 150 miles out off into the ocean. You lose all signal, you lose all cell phone, you lose everything. It takes radio to communicate. I say this because the purpose of all that is in 1965, the government took out of all the Britannicas and all of the encyclopedias that the world had a firmament, that the world was flat. It was illegal to teach the world was round until the 1900s. And then in the 1950s, they changed it so that the world was a globe because they're trying to deceive you, because there's proof there's God on Earth. You can go drive your ass to Antarctica, except it's illegal because of a Treaty of Antarctica in 1965 that stops you from being allowed to go to actually Antarctica and see the giant ice wall that shows the firmament. We are trapped by an ice wall, and there is a firmament that will not let us go to the sky. We have never been to space. Those are celestial bodies out there. You can call me crazy. I'm trying to tell you the truth. I'm a very smart man. If you're so smart and the world is round, prove it to me, because I have been through every scenario. I have done all of the math. This world is not round. I'm telling you that because once you realize that's not true, all the other things that aren't true start to become apparent. And why are they lying to you? Why would they tell you the world is round? Because if the world is round, there's no firmament. If we've been to space, the first 7 pages in the Bible is a lie. But you read the Bible, and it talks about the firmament. We can't escape the firmament. You can't get past it. That is what separates us from the heavens. What are the heavens? The moon is a celestial body God gave for us to keep time. We're supposed to keep time by the moon. That's why there's supposed to be 13 months. This is going to be a few-minute conversation because there's so much information that we're being lied to. And the purpose of that lie is to deceive you from the actual fact that God exists, he's real, and there's actually proof of it here on Earth. People always say, well, how do you know, blah, blah, and all this other religions. No. And I don't care. You believe whatever religion you want to believe. I'm just telling you, the earth is flat, not round. And that is mind-boggling. I'm still shook by this. You don't understand. Like, I'm still shook on this, but can't prove it to be round. It's impossibly not round. We don't spin at 18,000 miles an hour. There's a whole lot of things. Satellites aren't in our actual sky. You know, astronauts, if all the astronauts that have ever actually been to space, even according to NASA, it's only 3, and those are the ones that went to the moon, but they never went to the moon, and they'll even tell you that by their own accord. This is all a fake lie. Why are they lying to us? What is the purpose? What is the agenda? And it's for the devil to deceive us. It's crazy. I know I sound like a hypocrite. I know what this sounds like. Believe me, I was one of y'all. I was a round earther up until like 2 months ago, but it's not round. Prove it's round, because you can't. And I'm not trying to be funny, but I couldn't, and I've done everything. The only most complicated thing is explaining day and night. Everything else is 100% explainable, flat, not round. Y'all have a blessed day. Chew on that. Think I'm stupid? I get it. I would too, because I really did think people who thought flat earth were stupid. But they're right. And you got to think about it to figure it out. Have a blessed day. When you find out that truth, find out that God loves you and he's real. And there's proof of that out there. Have a great day. Look at Antarctica, the treaty. Look into the firmament. Look into the ice wall. 1965 Britannicas or encyclopedias show exactly where that firmament wall is and at what altitude it is, to the point that you can calculate how high the dome is at the center point on Earth, the firmament that we can't get past. All this is provable and mathematical. Have a blessed day.
Let me explain something to you about how brainwashing works. You never know that you're brainwashed until you wake up from being brainwashed. So if you haven't woken up yet, guess what? You still are.
Flat Earth. I was a skeptic too until I went down this rabbit hole. I saw this on Telegram back in 2021. They were any big voices talking about Flat Earth. Very strange. Then I found this guy on YouTube. He is extremely smart. Check out his TikTok. He's a total Flat Earther. And he showed this picture here of all of these depictions of flat earth from like ancient knowledge. Why are they in all these different countries all around the world? That's weird. Then I found this guy's TikTok talking about how NASA originally was created to explore the oceans. Now they explore space. And this guy's asking, what did they find in the ocean? This really took the cake. Someone posted a video of a guy who found a lake in an ocean. Okay, and then it showed this eel going into the lake and it disappeared. And then he tried to go into this lake with his submarine and the submarine would not go penetrate. Okay, and when the eel came back up, it was like seizuring, then it died. It's almost like it was a portal in the ocean. And what is even more weird is this guy had a freak helicopter crash and died. Him and his film crew died after they posted this. I still don't know, but I'm getting more and more suspicious.
Toilet fort proved me wrong, but the earth is flat.